An 87-year-old Daytona Beach woman is tricked out of a small fortune.
Police say she's able-bodied, not senile, but because of her kind heart, she fell for a sob story.
And it turns out it was an elaborate scam. She lost $62,000. WESH 2's Claire Metz is live at the Publix on Bevel Road, where the suspects befriended the victim. Claire.
Yeah, Jim, and police are certain these suspects, a man and woman, have done this before, watching for someone vulnerable. Our victim, who, by the way, is so embarrassed and upset, won't go on camera, pulled into a handicapped parking space right here. A lone elderly woman, well, she was the one.
And have these scumbags come in here and do what they did to her, it just turns your stomach.
Chief Mike Chitwood knows the victim personally. He's spoken to her and other seniors in the Pelican Bay community about scams, flimflams. Yet when the 87-year-old was approached by a woman outside Publix, the woman pictured here in a wig and sunglasses. The victim told the chief she fell hard.
She was so forceful and so convincing that I thought, you know, I need to do this. I want to help this person out. And then it just snowballed. From there.
The female suspect, who claimed to be a Publix employee, asked the victim to give her a ride to nearby Sam's Club. That's where police say the male half of the duo was waiting in the wings with a story about needing money to get back to Sudan to collect hundreds of thousands of dollars from his royal family and turn it over to charity. The female suspect accompanied the victim to Wells Fargo, where the victim withdrew $12,000 cash from her account.
They got $12,000 from her, and they pushed her for even more money. And she went for it.
The victim told the duo she could get $50,000 more from her Pelican Bay home in her safe. Again, the female suspect went with her while the man waited at Sam's. Police say it's a miracle the victim wasn't murdered.
I mean, she took this woman to her house where she opened up a safe where there was a hell of a lot more in that safe than $50,000. And she didn't end up dead or duct taped and, you know, we didn't find her for days.
The suspects fled from Sam's in this white Nissan Altima. Police are checking surveillance for more images. One of the tellers at the Wells Fargo was very suspicious about the transaction, repeatedly asked the victim if she wanted to do this. Why not use money orders that could be replaced? The victim was adamant. And I talked to Wells Fargo corporate, who said they would not necessarily call 911 in a situation like this because it could be an invasion of privacy. However, they are looking over all of their policies. Meanwhile, police here would like to offer a reward of $2,500 for any information leading to arrests. Reporting live in Daytona Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.